Hey everybody, today I'm out here in North Carolina and Toyota has just pulled the covers off of what they're calling the concept for the 2021 Toyota Mirai. The Mirai is Toyota's hydrogen fuel cell vehicles. This is a direct competitor to something like the Honda Clarity or the Hyundai Nexo. Even though the Nexo is a crossover, it's also a fuel cell vehicle. Now, although they're calling this a production concept, it really looks like it's ready for production. We have the same full LED headlamps that we see in a lot of other Toyota models, and the front end definitely has a Toyota sort of Avalon vibe to it. But the rest of this Mirai looks an awful lot like a Lexus, and a total departure from the current generation Mirai, which I really think is a great thing. Although we don't know a lot of details about this generation Mirai, we do know that it's going to be rear-wheel drive, which is another significant departure from the current generation model, and definitely going to be a differentiator between this and something like the Clarity. The other thing that's going to be a differentiator between the current Mirai and the Clarity is the gorgeous profile we get from this vehicle because of the rear-wheel drive nature. This looks an awful lot like the Lexus LS. Now, we don't have any confirmation from Toyota about this, but I suspect this is probably going to be closer related to the current generation LS500. Again, rear-wheel drive, no power figures available yet, no range figures available yet, nothing along those lines, but they're telling us to expect about a 30% range improvement, which could put this over the 400-mile mark. At the moment, we don't know exactly how Toyota has gotten to the 400-mile mark. I suspect that they've added an additional tank to the Mirai's fuel system, so this might have 3 or 4 spun element tanks, sort of along the lines of the Nexo, again, different than the current generation Mirai. They're telling us to expect increased cargo capacity in the back. If they've placed the tanks underneath the vehicle, then that really could get us to that improved cargo figure. It's a little bit unusual for me to be talking about a future vehicle like this, but I'm particularly interested in the Mirai because I do have a fuel cell vehicle myself. I do own a 2019 Hyundai Nexo, and this could very easily be its replacement in California. Unfortunately, Toyota did not have a real interior for us to experience, but they did have some high-resolution photos of their prototype model. On the inside, you can see that the overall design is a huge departure from the current generation Mirai. We have a dashboard design that is much more modern feeling with much larger LCDs, including a large 12-inch color touchscreen right in the middle. We're told that this will support the latest in smartphone integration, so expect Apple CarPlay and Android Auto both. Overall, the interior design definitely looks an awful lot more Lexus than the current generation Mirai or something like the Toyota Prius or Prius Prime, and that's certainly what Toyota was going after with this model. In fact, this even uses the current generation Lexus LS500 steering wheel. Now again, we don't have too many details on exactly what's going on underneath the skin of the new Mirai, but I suspect this is going to be pretty closely related to the Lexus LS, and that's why we do find some of the other buttons in this interior, as far as the pictures go, that are borrowed right out of that LS500. Materials quality definitely looks to be a serious improvement over the current generation Mirai, so you can probably expect the price tag is going to bump up as well. I wouldn't be surprised if this ended up right around $70,000, because that's pretty much where something like the Hyundai Nexo ends. For pricing and any firm details, you will have to wait until the end of calendar year 2020, when we should know more about this generation Mirai, and we should know more about things like rear seat room. Overall, I suspect this is going to be an improvement over the current generation Mirai, but it's probably not going to be too far off of the Toyota Camry. Even though at about 195 inches long, this is longer than something like the current generation Camry, it's based on what appears to be, again, the Lexus LS platform. So you can think of this as sort of a short wheelbase Lexus LS500. That means that we're going to get less rear legroom in the back than we find in the current generation LS, but likely very similar headroom, depending on exactly where all the hydrogen tanks have been located. At this point in time, Toyota has not said when this is going to go on sale, but it is going to be a 2021 model year vehicle. And again, this is theoretically not the model we'll be seeing actually on sale, but we're told this is pretty close to that overall design. I think the real high point for the Mirai for 2021 is going to be the interior and the exterior design and the fact that this is rear-wheel drive. Now, we again don't know power figures in this particular model, but if it is at least 250 horsepower, I'd say this is really going to be a solid, interesting argument in the luxury segment. And I'm actually a little surprised that Toyota didn't call this a Lexus in America. I asked them several times, why didn't the Mirai turn into a Lexus? They told me that basically the Mirai is sold worldwide and its primary market is going to be in Japan, where they have a separate Lexus brand, and they didn't think that this vehicle fit into that portfolio. They also want Toyota to be known as a green or alternative fuel vehicle brand, and so this vehicle will help them with that particular image in America. If you want to know more about the Mirai, we should have another video after the Tokyo Motor Show where we will get additional details on the future 2021 Mirai. Be sure to hit that subscribe button down there at the bottom of your screen for that video. It'll come up over the next few weeks. I'll see you all later.